Welcome to the lecture series of Principles of Programming. In this session, I'll be discussing the previous year question paper, which has happened in the year of June-July 2023. So I'm focusing on module 3. There are three questions. Similarly, you can expect in the forthcoming examination also. Question number 5A, what was the question? Explain the syntax of function declaration and function definition with example. If you write syntax of function declaration, you will be getting 3 marks. If I talk about the function definition, you will be getting another 3 marks. That is a division. So let me discuss in brief function declaration in C programming. So a function declaration tells the C compiler about the function's name, then return type and types of parameter that you are supposed to remember. These 3 points are most important. It doesn't include the function body. It just gives the compiler heads up about the function. So give the brief introduction like this. Okay, 3 parameters you have to talk about. Okay, now syntax will be in this fashion. So like return type, then function name you can put. It may be like input or it may be like whatever it may be. Then parameter type 1, parameter type 2, etc. So we have like a return type. It can be like a int, float, double, void, etc. Function name will be like, you can give the name of the function. You can assign the name of the function. Then parameter type, the types of the input which the function accept. So this is a general syntax which is applicable for function declaration. Try to add the syntax and elaborate it. Also, we can give an example. See, int. So return type int. Then this is the name of the function. Inside you can put the parameter. This is actually the way how the function will be declared. So int is the data type. Okay, it's a return type. We can call it as return type. Add is the user defined function. I'm going to create a new function called add. Then parameters will be giving like a variable A and B, right? Yeah. So this is actually the simple way of declaring the function. So now function definition. Function definition is where you write the actual code that the function executes. Then it provides the logic or body of the function. Now look at this. A function name, everything we are going to declare later. You can see int add int a comma int b, then return a plus b. So add function will be operated. It's a user defined function. You will be getting the sum of 2 variables a plus b. This is actually the function definition. Okay, altogether we can write like a declaration of the function and function definition in this particular fashion. So we have library, then we have function declaration in this fashion. This is syntax we already familiar, data type, name of the function, parameters. Afterwards, you can call the function. Okay, then you can define the function in this fashion. So add will act as a user defined function here. Okay, that's all. So 3 plus 3 will be getting 6 marks. So there is another important program which I have found many question paper. I think you can see this particular question. Write a C program to swap the 2 numbers using call by reference methods. Need algorithm and step-by-step explanation. So first of all, you have to start the program, declare 2 variables, which has to be swapped, then declare the function swap. You are supposed to define new function called the swap. In the swap function, use temporary variable. Okay, like select the temporary variable, temp that is equal to star A, because we require swapping now. A, B, C, then B, A will be stored in B, C will be stored in B, like that. Some swapping you have to do it, right? Then another temporary function, that is star A, star A, that is equal to star B. So star B will be stored into star A. Then star B is equal to temp, right? So call the swap function, the main, and pass the addresses A and B respectively. So print the value of A and B. And after the swap, then you'll be ending the program. So if you write the algorithm, surely you'll be getting another 2 or 3 marks. It is most important. So once you design the algorithm, once you developed the algorithm, let's go to the programming. Okay. The programming will be like, we have library, then swapping of 2 numbers using call by reference. So first of all, create the function called swap, then declare the variable, then create the temporary functions in this particular fashion. You can declare the variables A and B, then print before swapping what will be the result, then afterwards print after the swapping what could be the result, then return 0. So if you write this program, you are able to get the swapping of numbers. Instead of 5, 10, you'll be getting 10, 5. Okay, you can verify the output as well by using the proper C compiler if you have. Question number 5b. I think it's clear to everybody. Question number 5B. Yeah. So even you can see the logic also, individual explanation, include the required libraries, hash include stdio.h, okay, main library, then so define the swap function, swapping logic inside the swap function in this particular manner. Then in the main function, you can declare the variable, then you can verify before swapping and after the swapping, okay. So like in this particular thing, before swapping, A is equal to 5, B is equal to 10. After the swapping, A is equal to 10, B is equal to 5. That's all. That could be the expected outcome. So question number 5C, let's see question number 5C. Describe different type of storage classes with example. This is also one of the most important theoretical type question. Like four type of classes will be there. Each classes carries 2 marks. 4 into 2 is equal to 8 marks. Yeah, now look at this. First of all, you have to talk about the different type of storage classes. Which determine scope, lifetime, and visibility. That is the importance of storage class. They helps to specify how and where the variables are stored and default values. Basically, four type of storage class are available in C programming. What are they? Number one, automatic storage class. Second one, static storage class. Third one, external storage class. Ultimately, register storage class. For your convenience, I prepared entire thing in a tabular format so that you will be getting a better idea. So request you go through the table once. Okay, even you can go for explanation also. So in the first column, you can see the storage class. Then second column, the keyword which is used in the programming. Third one, I'll be talking the parameters like a scope, lifetime, default value, and the usage. For example, register, that is used for fast access. If I talk about external, that is mainly used for global variable across the files. Like that, I have mentioned the tabular form so that you can grasp very fastly and you can present it in a better fashion. So each function I have written regarding automatic, local variables by default existing during the function's execution. That is the importance of automatic. So the automatic storage classes, the duty will be given. Static storage class, the duty is keep its value across the multiple calls. Ideal for counters and or retaining state. External will be like shares the global variable across the multiple files or function, and the register duty will be suggest the faster access for frequent used variable, especially loop counters. So these are the major type of storage classes which is used in the C program. So thank you very much for watching this video. Let me know if you have any queries. I'm happy to answer that. Happy learning. Have a great day.